competition is everywhere. Whether the tea is growing, a child is growing, or something. So competition is growing. Whether it is done by God, whether someone believes in God, that depends. But competition is done. And this competition is not done by your CPU. Okay, so there must be other competition model available in nature. Agreed? So we are always, as a computer scientist, it's all our deal. We find various computer science gadgets so that we can do the computer science. So it's the LLM being developed, and at that time digital logic is of not there, nothing is there. We just do it on a simple strip of paper. We block 1 and 0 and like this. But whatever he has done, till now, that is the sacrosanct. That is, what is the sacrosanct feature of Alan Turing? 1936, he says, the basic notion of computing. What can be computed? What cannot be computed? That is still now. I do not believe this will remain forever. So, no theory is not forever. Right? Newton's theory is not forever. Einstein's theory is not forever. So, definitely will be changed. But still now, this notion of computability still holds. So, here, anything if you can find that any algorithm, you cannot find a Turing machine that is not an algorithm. That is the hard thing. Whenever you are teaching in algorithm class, whatever thing you cannot do this kind of computation, that is not algorithm. So anything which is algorithm means what? Algorithm means a recipe. Algorithm means BCD calculation. What the algorithm means, it has some start condition, it's an end condition, and it must stay. So algorithm means that. So this is it. So let's see what is the Turing machine configuration. So this is Q, this is a tape alphabet, this is tape alphabet, and this is tape of financial machine. Tape of financial machine, and this is tape alphabet, and after this, it will go one of the state function. This is the cross product. That is a product, and then it will go either left or right. Only one step. This is very vital. We go only left step, but it cannot be stationary. Okay? Turing machine cannot be stationary. So, like this, it's a sample transition function of the data function. The Turing machine in Q state, and it is seeing the A. The reading A is the A. Then it goes to state R, and the reading end A is changed by B. It can be by C also. And it goes left. Then it goes left, or then it can take B, then it goes right. This is the standard way of writing transition function. And this is another way how the Turing machine configuration. See, if you are the strip of paper, if you are a Q7 here, so your configuration and machine will be there. Q7 is in front of you. So here, this is the cube state. So this is the big cell. Here it goes, so this will be written like this. Any question till now?
So what does the
Q7 indicate? Yeah, Q7 is nothing a number which is within Q. Q0 is the same initial state. Q7 may be accepting, may be rejecting 9 and 7 here. But all the states must be Q. But one great thing about the Turing machine, like here, I am reading the Turing machine definition. In finite state machine, we have 5 tuple. In finite state machine, reading machine and Moore machine, we have 6 tuple. What is the 6 tuple? That is output alphabet. That is PDA. And PDA, how many tuples we have? 6 tuple. Because we have gamma as alphabet. Here we have 7 tuple. That we can remember. Here it is a tape alphabet, not the stack alphabet, tape alphabet. It must include this bag. In some books, it is written there in bag, but some books it is written here. Okay, so here. So your question is, what is Q7? Q7 is nothing but a state, meaning number of all states, and states can belong to maybe acceptance state or rejected state. We never now, or all other machine, finite state machine or PDA, you don't have reject set of state. Here you have reject. And if any particular condition, the Turing machine neither accept nor reject, right? Goes on that time. Then what we call the purification? The purification, not halting. Purification, not halting. And that is a very serious condition. That purification is from harm, but we generally need, or previous generation, the machine is hungry. So that is, if it is not accept, it is not reject, the cooling machine continuously looping, that is the cooling machine is not decidable. If cooling machine halts, cooling machine halts at two times, either accept or reject. But if it doesn't halt, that means cooling machine is having inordinate amount of time and it is looping around. That is the problem is not decided. Cooling machine doesn't talk, that means problem is not decided. Agree? Any question till now? Have you got your answer? 2780? Any others? Good. Idea what we have here, so that is the logic. We are making the cooling machine as early as possible because till now the class attendance is good. Maybe at the when the cooling machine is due to the class at that time, attendance might low. And maybe at CFO, so we start cooling machine as quickly as possible. Next 2 to 3 class will be on cooling machine and variants of cooling machine, that will be more interesting. Why it is most interesting? Cooling machine, Alan Turing is considered the father of computer science, like Albert Einstein and Newton and physics. Okay, and there are another this is theory of computer power and in automotive, even the Noam Chomsky's other great gentleman, he's still living there at the age of 93. Okay, so why is the Alan Turing is interesting? At that time, several models have been done, and Alan Turing guide is chart. And in your syllabus, you see the charge Turing thesis. The charge Turing thesis says that any such problem, can be represented in object this state. Okay? And if it is represented in object, there is an algorithm. If there is no algorithm, you cannot. What is the difference between algorithm? Algorithm takes not all problems thesis. Your algorithm is meant to solve problems. Your problem should have some data. Your algorithm should depend on data or not. Tell me. If your data have, say, 1,000 pieces, so your algorithm should depend on 1,000 pieces or 100 pieces. Please answer me. Please? Yes. That's a big thing. So algorithm should, if your algorithm is dependent on 1,000 pieces of data, that means even if it is 10,000 pieces, your algorithm changes. But algorithm should not change. Algorithm should be run on sample amount of data and it should work. If it should work, then the full set of data, it will work. So that is called algorithm. Algorithm is nothing but a recipe, it's a steps. So if you can get an algorithm, that can be done on Turing machine and that will arrive in an Alenco chart that decided in 1936. And right now, so many models of computation, like quantum computing, DNA computing, and other computations are there, but still now this holds true. I don't know how long it will hold true, but this Turing machine can solve any algorithm. If you cannot write anything in algorithm, but that cannot be seen in PDA. In PDA, it can solve only WWR or W#WR. But if it is a WW, you have to take the case of the Turing machines. Okay, WW, because you know. It cannot show you. So here is basically what we have done. This is a W#W. This is a W#W. So how to check it? How the cooling will do? First, the cooling logic is there W#W. So W#W, the first it will check whether this is there. The first it will check before getting it. First check is there. If this check is not there, then it will go to the reject state. Okay. So one good thing about the FSA and PDA, your input has to go at the end. Christian language. It is not a context free language. Zero simple variance is a context free or context free language. Getting a context free, is it a context free language? You cannot put it to 80 power and 50 power. It is not possible. If you take this symbol, you cannot take given U, V, I, U, V, W, X, Y.
CML language mark grammar CML
or 1,000 by computers, and you say it is okay. This is undesirable. There are lots of problems. In fact, 99.9% problems are undesirable. See, Sri Lanka is living under diesel. Who has thought is in Sri Lanka is got under this? So everything we cannot predict. Even in our case, we do not predict what happens. UK, one of the best countries in Europe, is now diesel. In the world also, there is lots of problems we cannot predict. The same thing is here. In actual machine condition, there are many problems are undecided. One difference is they are undecidable and highly computed. Like if you go for traveling salesman problem, your connections, your options is 2 to the power 8, factorial 8. That is a huge number, exponential number. You know the problem of polynomial problem. Polynomial problem A is an A, N squared, N cubed, or maybe 2 to the power 8. It is a, you know, the tower of Hanoi. And then maybe 2 to the power 8 factorial is the problem of, say, your traveling salesman problem, macroscopy. So these problems are exponential. But this has a solution. But some problems you cannot find algorithm. If communication doesn't help me, communication is algorithm. The algorithm is faulty. Algorithm is faulty. That's a great test that algorithm is faulty. Answer the question. So any other question?
Sir, in spite of the disadvantage that we are having in Turing machine, how can we implement that in the other?
Thank you. A good question. Actually, there is, when the Turing has developed, there is no such computing machine setting. No finite state machine, no push-down computer. Turing machine, Turing developed is by a hand paper. Turing has thought that any problem in mathematics can be solved by a square boxes putting 1, 0 and ticking off 1 or 0 at a time by left or right with some logic. It is not arbitrary that 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. One logic brings it different things backward and forward, and if the result can be printed here. That same theory still holds true. So, one thing you can check in your algorithmic class also, in any algorithm, say the dynamic search, dynamic programming, you know, greedy programming, all problem can be done by a Turing machine. But it might take more time, but here we are not complex, we are not going to the time complexity. Like in algorithm, we go in for time complexity. Say here, which problem can be solved by like a to the power n, g to the power n problem? We will solve not by Turing machine. Turing machine can solve. We solve it with a push on it. Any problem which can be done by regular grammar, we call it finite state machine. But WWR, or WHWR problem, we will solve it by Turing machine. Turing machine is the most powerful. Now, you can think of Turing machine, you have a multiple head, multiple tail, non-deterministic Turing machine, but it can be shown that all machine power, what does it mean power? Power means it doesn't make you quick. In computer science, formal language and automata theory, power means whether it can understand any extra language, they will call extra power. Turing machine doesn't have any extra power, but Turing machine may solve the problem in a slower that you were mentioning at that time. The PDA is definitely faster for PDA specific problem, but Turing machine is the ultimate test whether the algorithm is okay or not. Any confusion? Good question. So now you have to go through the Alan Turing paper or modifiable Turing machine, and next day we'll go for further into Turing machine. We'll see. But you always remember Turing machine is 7 tuple, FSM is 5 tuple, Millibool is 6 tuple, PDA is 6 tuple, and Turing machine is 7 tuple. You have you reject and you accept. And one interesting is Turing machine when not false. When not false, that means Turing machine hangs, and that is undecidable. Thank you. Thank you very much for the question. So I think it's okay.